Have you got mineral deficiencies on your lettuce? This is what we're going to see together in this video. So I received an email from Nitish, who has some issues apparently on the growth of his lettuce, and he sent me some pictures to have my opinion on the health of those lettuce. So before trying to find an answer for Nitish, and it's going to be challenging, I just want to explain you what is the idea with deficiencies in aquaponics. So we are growing food in aquaponics in a closed environment, and the only media we have is scoria, which is a volcanic rock. I mean scoria here in Melbourne aquaponics, but you can also use clay balls, you can use gravels, plenty of different media are available. But for me, the cheapest one here in south of Australia, in Melbourne, I really believe that is the scoria, because it's a volcanic rock, very cheap and has a very high surface area. Anyway, the purpose of the media is to increase, to offer a good surface for the bacteria to live on. So we got our grow bed here that is full of media of those rocks. Right now, the issue that we have in aquaponics, it's not a real issue, but that's a little challenge, is that there are no minerals that are added in the system, and we always grow plants and we harvest plants. So those plants are absorbing the few minerals that are in the water at the beginning. Obviously, every day we are feeding our fish. In the fish food, there are some minerals. There is potassium, there is calcium. There are a bunch of minerals, but there are some minerals that may be deficient depending on the quantity of and the biodiversity of food that you are growing. If you are growing a lot of plants that need a lot of iron, for example, or potassium, you may have some deficiencies. So when you grow your plants, you may find some leaves that are turning yellow or looking a bit weak, and that may be due to the fact that you are light in one type of mineral. So some experts, gardeners, apparently they would be able, by looking at the plants, to tell you exactly what type of mineral is deficient. I will be very honest with you, it is not my case. Very, very difficult to tell exactly what type of mineral is deficient just by looking at the plant. There are some tendencies. Sometimes you can see the plant that is going gray from the side of the leaf. Sometimes it's through the veins. So it gives you some ideas. But sorry, it's very, very tricky to say exactly. I can see the leaf and I can tell you that's potassium deficiency. By the way, if some of you are able to do that by looking at the picture, please give the response to Nitish, because he's wondering what is the problem with his lettuce. When I look at the picture, I can see that obviously the old leaves are not looking good. But for me, you know, it always happens when you are growing lettuce. The young leaves are always growing. And after a while, the old leaves, they get a bit older and they just die off while the young ones are growing again. It's a normal cycle. It happens every time. When you go to the supermarket, if you don't see old leaves that are dead, it's because they have been cleaned before being harvested. So for me, it's a normal process to see the old leaves a bit gray. Now, obviously, from the pictures, we can't tell much, if the young leaves are also deficient, if they are not nice green but they are a bit yellow, yes, you may have a deficiency. So then it's very tricky to tell you just by one picture what is a deficiency. So first you need to look at the quantity of sunlight that is available for the plant. You know, every plant needs a certain intensity of sunlight, and if they don't have enough sunlight, they may not develop the best color and they may not give you the best productivity, the best growth. Then you got the temperature. You may have issues with temperature. Then you have nitrogen. You need to make sure you got enough nitrogen in your water for the plant. It's always tricky to know, because sometimes as soon as the nitrogen is produced, thanks to the bacteria, when I say nitrogen, I'm talking about nitrate. sometimes as soon as it's produced, it's consumed by the plant. So you don't really see the high level in the water, and you don't want to see high levels in aquaponics, because we have fish, it's very different to hydroponics, where we can allow ourselves to go to high concentration of nitrate. We can go to 300 ppm, 500, even more, depending on the species we want to grow. Here in aquaponics, we don't want to go above 50-100, because then obviously the fish wouldn't be in good conditions. So we have to be careful of this, and it makes sense that we can't be in the optimum of the plant, but we can give a good substrate for the plants, for them to grow nicely. So nitrate is one of them, and then you got all the minerals. So I was talking about minerals, so obviously calcium, potassium. Well, anyway, you got 12 minerals that are very important, and then you got all the minerals that are also important in smaller quantities. So it's always very difficult for me to respond to those type of questions. Iron is one of those minerals that when you put it in aquaponics, because of the presence of oxygen, the water and the pH, you always got the iron that is turning into rust. You got an oxidation and becomes unavailable for the plant. So it's always a good idea to add a bit of chelated iron if you see some deficiencies on your leaves. That's the first thing to do, and also to add a bit of rock dust or a mix of minerals that you can buy from any gardening shop. This is going to help you to hopefully fix this deficiency problem. Also, if you are growing the food you plant in a greenhouse, sometimes you got too much moisture, and it helps some mold to grow, some type of fungus. So in this case, there is no need to add more minerals. It's just because you got too much moisture in the greenhouse. So you got a multiple quantity of factors. You know, it's not just the plant, it's also the environment. We need to know how you are growing the plant, in what type of environment. Is it in a greenhouse? Is it full sun? Is it full shade? What is the temperature? What is your nitrate level? What type of plants are you growing with it? Is it only one type, or is it a lot of plants? You know, it's quite tricky to respond to this question just by seeing a picture. But I hope I give you some good tips to have a look at the different parameters and trying to find what can be the issue for you. If issue there is, right? Because from seeing the picture, I don't see a massive issue. I see that the old leaves are not going well, but it's very hard for me to tell if the plant is going well or not. You know, if you see if it's producing or if it's not. Also, here in Melbourne right now, we are in the beginning of spring, the temperatures are not very high. So during this time of the year, you can't expect a high productivity. It's going a bit slow. It's producing, but it's a bit slow. So you got all those parameters to take in consideration. So Nitish, I hope it helps you, and please give us your comment in the video, below the video. Anyone you can help Nitish, if you have any idea, any feedback to give, it's in the comment of the video. If you want to start aquaponics, you can have access to the six-step process to build your own aquaponics system. It's a free training that is available in the description of the video just below. I give you some tips, and I give you the ratio to respect, the limit to respect when you want to build your aquaponics system, to build it in the good conditions, to make sure that you are going to avoid the common mistakes and that you're going to maximize the productivity of the system. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. It really helps the channel, and also you can subscribe. I see you in the next video. Bye bye.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop.